Hi guys, Donna McElvaney here, and we're going to do planned pooling today again. This time we're going to use Macaw, and Macaw uses an eye hook. Alright, so I'm going to get my 5.5 millimeter, my eye hook. It's typically the one that I use a whole lot with right now with pooling, and it's on most of the skeins itself. So we're just going to start right in. I've never done this one before, so we're going to kind of do this one together. So I'm gonna pull out the yarn here, and I've never seen the color sequence of this yarn, so I'm gonna pull it out and check it out here and see what we got going. Let's see, it's very, very pretty. And it's a little different. All right, I saw a couple of short. Just keep on pulling. Let's see here. All right, so I pulled all this out. I'm gonna go ahead and look for a repeating pattern here. All right, see what I can find. Such pretty blues are in this one. This one here kind of gradually changes. I don't see a definite change in that one, so we'll probably count that one as one. From here we have this real pretty teal that goes into a small lighter section, and then it goes back into that same color again. So I'm going to see if I can find another one that looks just like that one. Good question, because some of these look so much alike. Okay. I think maybe I found it, but maybe not. So I'm just going to go ahead and start chaining. And then once the chains are a bit smaller, the chains make the yarn not as long. That's what I'm trying to say. And more solid, you can definitely see the colors better. So I'm just gonna start chaining it because I didn't really find a definitive repeating pattern. So I'm just gonna go with the air, see what I can find. It definitely makes the color stand out a bit more. It makes them more solid, more able to identify. I'm just going to chain along. See what I can find. Sometimes it's awkward doing it in the position that I'm doing it in so that I can record. So I'm just going to keep on going here. There's this real, real pretty blue color in here. I'm going to see if there's a repeat from the
nice royal blue to the next royal blue. See if that's where a repeat is at. I'm gonna stop and see what I got so far here. Alright, so here's what I've changed so far. Alright, this pretty royal blue color, teal, a shadier blue, and then royal blue, teal with a little bitty splash. That teal's got that little splash there. And then here's a little bitty short segment that's separating this duskier blue and this royal blue, which is a short segment. Teal. Alright, so I haven't found a repeat yet, so I'm just going to keep on going. All of my planned pooling projects are all wind up being throws, throw blankets, Afghan throws, and all wind up being, most of them are gifts. I have had a few orders, which is really awesome. I've also done one for a benefit auction that is quickly approaching. It's not quite finished yet, I'm still working on it. And that one is antique. I did a previous video on antique. I didn't realize that macaw had such a long sequence before it repeats. I had several to choose from tonight, and I thought, oh, let's do this one. Yeah, this one's kind of long, so that's okay. Alright, I wonder if this is that one section that's got that, that little bit of a splash there in the middle. Let me see if this happens to repeat, and it does not. Not yet. Nope. Still not repeating yet. Wow. And I thought Woodsy was long. We're just going to keep on chaining until we find a repeat. There's got to be a repeat in here somewhere. This one here is perfect for somebody who loves blues and all different colors of blues. They go very nicely together, and I think this one is going to be gorgeous. I actually have two people. I'm going to make two of these. The first one, though, I'd really like to have it done in, like, less than 2 weeks. I'm still working on antique, and antique is due by the same deadline that I want this one to be done by. But I have to get antique done first. I'm about 3 skeins in on antique. I've got 2 more to do and then a border. And I usually fly through them pretty fast. Are we repeating yet? Surely there's a repeat in here somewhere. I did not choose a very easy one to do.
especially to film it while I did it instead of giving it a trial run first. Some of them I do a trial run first, but I also wanted to show how easy it is to pick up one and pull it, like, right away. I did not choose an easy one to do that with. But that's okay, because a lot of y'all have very difficult ones to do. So this can help with that. Look, there's a little splash. Maybe. I am just hoping that this is it. Close to it, at least. I don't know. Okay. Let me get to the end of this real pretty royal blue and see where I'm at with it. Okay. And that little splash may not be anything. In fact, it may be a dye lot flaw. I've had some of those lately and they really, really upset me. I have not found a repeat yet. I'm going to look for this section here. Maybe that'll be easier to identify. Sometimes it can be frustrating whenever you're going and going and going and then you can't find it. Let's see here. I'm still looking, bear with me. Okay, so it's dusky blue, teal, royal blue. That's real short. I'm looking here. Dusky blue, teal, royal blue, short. Dusky blue, teal. Oh, I think I found it. Oh. Please, please. I hope so. I'm going to go ahead and chain it through. I think I found what I'm looking for. Because I was starting to second guess. It's like, is Macaw on the list? Does Macaw pull? And I was like, oh man, I hope so, because I bought several skeins of it to make it into a couple of afghans. If it wasn't going to work, I was going to be just, oh man. I'd wind up turning it into a corner to corner or something instead, and I didn't want to do that because I love pulling. My other hooks are getting in the way. I do have an eye hook. Well, I'm using the eye hook. I do have a G hook and an H hook sitting here beside me, just in case it's needed. Sometimes it is. On occasion, you get to a color and it's too small and you got to jump all the way down to a G. What a long chain. Alright, thanks guys for bearing with me as I'm doing this. Alright, I think this is what I was looking for. I'm going to chain through it and make sure see, there's the dusky and the lighter teal and the royal blue and that lighter teal again that goes, just fades into a dark teal. Let's make sure that this matches. Oh, I'm praying so. Let's see. All right, let me find the other one here.
Looky there. It repeats. Oh, thank you, Jesus. We have found the repeat. Okay, now we're gonna decide where it starts. All right. Ah, that is like, sometimes that is the first major hurdle is finding the repeat. Okay, so this is where I began. And then this is my repeat here. As you can see, and verify it. All right, so the little part of the tail goes into this dark blue here, and then it goes into these colors. And it repeats. Yay, 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 yes. All right, gorgeous. This is gonna be gorgeous. All right, so it's very long. So what I'm gonna do is I'm going to find where my tail is right here, and then I'm gonna decide which one of these colors I'm gonna start with. Okay, so I started here. I'm going to start my turn. Let's start it. I'm gonna start my very next row with this color right here. So I'm going to frog it back to here. I'm just pulling away. I'm holding on to where I want it to be. Now, I've never done it like this before. Alrighty. But we're gonna try it and see, all right? So bear with me here. All right, so I'm gonna start the next row with this color here. So I want this one on my hook. Perfect. All right, so did you see what I did? I found the repeat. And then I just decided, I just kind of pick and choose. I could have went ahead and come all the way back here if I wanted to, but this is a definite color change, and I really like that, especially when starting out, especially whenever they fade, because see how some of these here, they kind of fade, and I didn't want to start really on a fade. So this is going to be interesting because of all the fades. It may get a little bit complex, so I'm just going to hope that this goes well. All right, so we're going to do the moss stitch. I haven't mastered the seed stitch turn yet. I kind of like it better, but I'm still used to doing the moss stitch and the modified puff at the end. So that's what we're going to do. Right now it's just easier. We go fourth from the hook. One, two, three, four. So we count that one as one, two, three, four. And I'm just going to moss stitch. I'm going to go all the way through it. I'm going to moss stitch. And with these colors too, I'm thinking since they fade out like they do, I don't want muddy stitches, but I might have some muddy legs. Alright, good. No muddy leg. And because the sequence is so long, I'm probably not going to be counting all of it. I'm going to show you here just how long. It's really, really, really long. So I don't think that I'm going to be counting. I'm going to do the mirror image like I did on Bright Mix. My last video was on Bright Mix. And it was a long one. I wasn't able to edit out, and I'm not able to edit this one out either. I apologize. So we're just gonna kind of go with it here. So we're gonna do a mirror image on a way to count our stitches, because the chain is too long to count and there's too many color changes in it. So when it's like this, it's really difficult to count at your first go around. So that one's kind of a split leg, and I don't want split legs because I'm not going to know which one to count it as. So here is a different color blue that goes into this blue. Probably going to count that section as like a whole section of blue. All right, but I'm going to tighten it up to get rid of that muddy stitch as it goes into the teal. Here we are. I'm gonna have enough here. Okay, and then I'm gonna go into the teal now. going into the dusky darker blue. I like to have two. I like to go under two of them instead of just one, because if you go into just one, it just kind of, it pulls up and it doesn't give it as good a foundation. So I like to go under two of them. Sometimes when the stitches are more loose, if you go under just one, it really pulls up and leaves a big gape, a big gaping hole, a big old gap in it, and it can look not quite right. And sometimes it can mess up the visual effect and also mess with like how you're crocheting it. That is a split leg. So I'm gonna, let's see, are these loose enough to tighten up? Still got it split. Two. I didn't tighten them up enough. Or maybe I need to loosen them up more. One of the two. I'm gonna tighten it up. Maybe I want to loosen it up because those are tighter than my others. And I'm gonna have to tighten them up like that all the way through it to make it work. So I made it into three stitches. This is how we're looking so far. Okay. I'll keep it that way. Yes, because now that I've completed this next color part, my leg landed pretty good, so I'm going to keep it that way. If I didn't like how this one came out, then I probably would have frogged it back to that point, and probably loosened them and see how the next color would have come out with it that way. Frogging it, that means to rip it, rip it. This is a very short one. Either tighten it and get two, or loosen it and only get one. Let's see here. I need to loosen it for one, because I'll go ahead and loosen it back to this one too. Because for two of them, it's gonna be super tight. So I'd rather loosen it up instead. Or not, because it's still quite a bit left on the hook. Loosen it a little bit more. go. It's kind of painful having to watch all the way through the first initial moss stitch row, especially when it's this long of a chain to have to moss through. And you have to remember too where we start at. So the only way to identify that probably is to, let's see, I'm gonna have to find that one section again and then pull it all the way back to where we start at. May have just been easier to start there at that one little short segment that we identified. Let's see, where did it go? I think I've already stitched over it. The section that had a real pretty blue. The short segment of the blue. The dusky, and then the teal, and then the royal blue, and then the teal. Because that's where I'm going to have to stop at. I'm going to have to stop at this segment here. So I'm going to have to be able to identify this segment here whenever I come around. So knowing me, I'm going to go past it, and then I'm going to have to frog back to where I need to be. So bear with me, please, whenever I do that, because I'm pretty sure I'm going to make errors in this. I'm probably going to go past it because I don't have a definite idea of exactly where it is. I started back at that point because that was where my beginning chain was. I wasn't really thinking it through on the how easy it is to identify that segment. It's not easy to identify it. It's a light segment. Okay, I recognize this segment. It's got the little splash of the light teal in it. Let's see, here's something that looks a little bit recognizable, but I still have, I don't think it's coming up yet because I've only done a short segment here. So I don't think it's quite where I need to be. So I'm gonna keep on going. Yeah, it's much easier to start your moss stitch row on a segment that you can easily identify. Like where I identified the repeat pattern, that's probably the best place to start your moss stitch row, is where you can identify it easily. But hopefully I'll be able to spot it pretty quick and not go too far past it. Don't want to add to the confusion. If you're a first time pooler, I would suggest you go with a different skein, something that's easier, something that has fewer colors in it. Antique is a good one. Zebra is a good one, just because it has fewer color changes. Fewer color changes do make it easier. Like the pink camo, and there's a light green looking camo one too. It may not be easy, but it looks like it has fewer changes than this does. And definite color changes, ones that don't bleed into the next ones. Just gonna keep going along here. What I've got. I do know that I start with the pretty royal blue and it goes into the light teal, and then royal blue that has a little bit of a lead into it, and then the darker teal. So whenever I see a section of royal blue, that one has a little bit of a lead in into the light teal turquoise. Am I almost to the repeat? Well, I think I may have just found it. Let me see here. I need to verify. Alright, so it's the dark blue. And then it's the teal, a lighter blue lead into royal blue. Teal, blue, and then it goes into the teal with the splash. Let me see here. Alright, so royal blue, lead in, light teal, that goes to darker teal. That's not what I wanted. Not what I wanted. Nope, I don't think I'm there yet. As I'm pulling out, I'm gonna go ahead and look for it. I think I found it, because I see that little bit of a light splash there. Nope, the next section I found it. Okay. All right, so I've identified my repeat. Yay, because that was a little tricky. Okay, so here is my royal blue that goes into that one. And then it goes into this color. And then this color. And pull it because of the chain. And then it goes into this color. Which then goes into this color. And then it goes into this color with the splash. Perfect. And then the darker teal. All right. Awesome. This is exciting. So I didn't go over my moss stitch row. I found it. Okay, so pulling it back to where it is. Okay. So in order to identify it, since I've identified it, but I've got all of this now pulled out that I have to moss stitch through. So what am I gonna do here? I'm gonna like get me something to mark it. Oh, so I'm gonna get up here a second. I'm gonna use what's handy. Okay, because I began my first moss stitch row with this color on my hook. I'm gonna mark this with a piece of tape. As easy as I can here. I'm gonna kind of loop it over like that so that hopefully I can remove it fairly easily. All right, so anything to mark it. I just happen to use what I've got handy here, and that's what I've got handy. So now I'm going to resume my mess of my repeat, and that's where I'm gonna go from. Okay, so I'm just gonna keep on going here. The next challenge, all right, is going to be doing the mirror image of your count stitches, because that is crucial, keeping your count stitch straight with, you don't want muddy legs, because muddy legs will mess up your count, because, okay, you got a half of a leg that's this color, and you got a half of a leg that's another color. Like here, I'm about to make it happen. So which color is it gonna be? Which color are you counting it as? So whenever you go through your first moss row, you wanna make sure you don't have muddy legs, because you wanna make sure that you have an accurate stitch count for whenever you go into your second moss stitch row. So I tightened it up to make it 2 stitches out of that one. And this is how you have to do it whenever you've got so many color changes, because they're not going to be exact. Color changes are going to be different. Color, like these short little color segments, not all of them are going to match up. You'll have 2 stitches of one, you'll have 3 stitches of another, and that's just the way it has to be throughout. So getting your first row is important with no muddy legs, and getting your second row is crucial, absolutely crucial, whenever you've got so many color changes. I'm wrapping up with my other hook here, I don't want that. I'm just crocheting along until I come up to the marked place. I've got so much yarn thrown everywhere here. Trying to separate it out a little bit. I got a little excited as I was throwing my yarn around. Now I got it wrapped up. I'm not sure how I did that, but I gotta. There we go. Okay, good. Oh, I'm gonna put my piece of tape section over here. Okay. All right. I'm excited that we found the repeat. And look here, I've got 1 stitch of that color. It's a really pretty turquoise, teal, whichever color it is. I think it's turquoise. That's a good color. And this lighter teal, turquoise, whichever one. Kind of pulled that a little bit tighter to, as I was going into the, where it kind of just blends into a darker color. So I'm going to moss stitch all the way to the tape. I'm definitely not counting these. I'm just counting, I'm making sure that my legs are not muddy. I tweaked that one a little bit tighter to make sure I didn't have muddy. We don't want muddy legs. We don't want split legs. It'll mess up our count whenever we go the next round. This macaw is beautiful. Oh, I did it again. I got it mixed. All right, pick up my hand. Whenever I pull yarn out, I tend to throw it to the left, but I've got the other yarn to the left and I don't want it over there. There, I throw it out that way. That's better. And I'm getting close to it. I've almost got it. Almost to the end here. A couple dozen left. It's really long. You definitely won't be doing 2 full color sequences of this one unless you're making like a king size bed or something. I split a leg. Let's see what I tighten to make it two. No. I messed up that one. I'm going to loosen it up and just make it one. It helps if you go back even several more stitches whenever you have to loosen up or even tighten. That way there, it eats up more of the yarn, and then you have the one stitch and you're going into the next color. I used to crochet really tight. And now I've loosened up quite a bit. I've made some bags. These cute, cute little bags. And I did them really, really tight. I think it made them sturdier. They held up a lot better. And they were super cute. I haven't made any in, I think I made those last year. And I sold a few of them, actually. It's pretty cool. It's nice whenever you get to create something and people actually like it and appreciate it, and they actually want to buy it from you, and they actually like order stuff. That's exciting and very rewarding. Sometimes though, it takes so much work to do it. And I live in a small podunk area, and it's really hard to get a good price for your work that you do. People just don't want to pay that for it. They think it's too much, and they just don't appreciate it. Or, you know, well, my grandma crochets, and I'll just have her make me something. Or you go into Walmart, and you see stuff that's crocheted and it's like $5 to $10. That really upsets me. And here I am coming to my tape. So I'm gonna take the tape off. Let's see here, did I go this way? Nope, I went this way. Or not. I'm just gonna cut it. So I know that once I get that next color on my hook, that is where I turn. So I am so excited. All right, so here is my next color on the hook. Whenever we get to the next color on the hook, this is the color that we want to start the next row with. So we actually have to take one back. All right. And starting out right away, I'm just going to go ahead and do it. I'm going to go ahead and do a modified puff stitch because I got to eat up some of this yarn here that I just pulled out. All right, so to do it, I want to do a modified puff on the one just before it. So I pulled out two stitches. I'm doing the modified puff on the one stitch. That actually counts as two stitches. All right, and now I'm going to turn and begin now with this one here. Yay! All right, so here we do the mirror image. I've got one, but I want to stop because I want to see how many do I have. So this is my turning chain. This was my turning chain, the dark blue, and I've got two of these. So I've got one. And two. And then, let's see, then I've got one, two, that go into the darker royal blue. That's three. So I've got one, two, that go into the darker royal blue. And I said that that is three. There's three darker royal blues. Whoopsies, I don't have a good grasp on that one. That happens sometimes. One, two, and I'm gonna go ahead and tighten it up because I'm already leading into the next color, and I think that's what I had done here. Yeah, one, two, three royal blues, and they're kind of tight. So I'm gonna go ahead and pull those back, and I'm gonna tighten that up. This is very important whenever you're doing a multi, lots and lots of color changes, that you do the exact mirror image. All right, and then I go into the teal. One, two, one, two, three, four. And then it goes into the dusky blue, which was two. One, two, three, and tighten it up a little bit just to make it to number four. Squeeze that one out so it wasn't a muddy leg. And then I believe I said I had two dusky dark blues. Yep, one, two, and then three of the royal. So we go one, two, and three of the royal. Am I going into the royal here? Kind of hard to tell. Let me see how many royals I'm going to get out of this. If not enough, then I'm going to frog it back to make sure I get a proper count. And I didn't. I only got two of the royals. Let me double check my work. Okay, so I went from this turquoise, two dusky, three royal. And then we got the little splash coming up. And we have the little splash coming up. Okay. So, I'm going to tighten these up all the way back to here. Make it a little bit tighter here. All the way back into this turquoise. One, two, three, did I say, hang on, let me double check here. One, two, three, four. Two. So I've got four of these turquoise. One, two, three, four, which is kind of muddy, so I'm gonna pull it back even further. All right, I'm gonna tighten them all up. And sometimes you're gonna have that, especially on your second row, because you wanna make sure that you're accurate. You're going to be doing quite a bit of frogging and correcting tension, adjusting tension. I won't say correcting tension, I'm going to say adjusting tension, because you're really not correcting it, it's really not wrong. You just have to adjust it to your first row. Alright, two of the dusty, and then three of the royal. So basically, you can count it as five if you want. It doesn't have to be exactly two dusty and then three of the royal. It could be five. As long as there's five of them there, then that's great. So if you're going from the dusty into the royal, and if you get like a split leg in here, as long as you're counting five of them, you can do that too. All right, now this long turquoise section with the splash, all right, now there's one, and then I know I have one splash. So let me go back here and look at my first row. All right, so there's one splash, one, two, three, four, two, and two. Sometimes I like to count ahead. All right, so there's four, and then two and two. One, two, three, four, and then two and two.
And this video is now 50 minutes long. So I'm gonna go ahead and stop this one here. Made it too tight, I gotta loosen it. I'm gonna go ahead and stop this video and I'm gonna begin segment number 2, because this intro took quite a while to get through the macaw. So that's what I'm gonna do. 2 and 2, get my 2 stitches here. And then I'm gonna go ahead and end this one and pick up with segment 2. Thanks everybody for watching, and go ahead and look for the second video, because I'm going to finish as we complete doing our mirror image.